Hi guys, welcome to our second tutorial in this series of programming PIC microcontroller with MPLAB XC8 compiler. In this tutorial, we will learn how to switch on and off an LED connected to a PIC microcontroller. This same concept of switching on and off an LED can be used to switch on any binary output like a relay, a buzzer, or even a transistor. A PIC output can handle about 25 milliamp. That's why it's important to always put a series resistor to limit this current. Otherwise, you can damage the output of the PIC. The intensity of the LED depends on the forward current that passes through the LED. The larger this current, the brighter the LED. But we must always pay attention not to exceed the maximum allowable current that can pass through the LED. Otherwise, we can damage it. Or even the maximum current that a pin of a PIC can be able to supply. A pin of a microcontroller output can supply up to 25 milliamp. So we have to make sure that the current that is gonna go through the LED mustn't be over 25 amp. To be able to limit this current, we have to know the voltage drop of each LEDs so that we can be able to calculate the value of the series resistor. This table shows a typical voltage drops of typical LEDs. A red LED with 20 milliamp forward current will have a typical voltage drop of 2 volt. An orange 2 volt, a yellow LED 2.1 volt, a green 2.2, a blue 3 volt, an infrared 1.2 volt. From Ohm's laws, series resistor is going to be equal to voltage divided by current. The current that is going to go through the LED, let's say if we need 10 milliamp, then the resistor is going to be 5 volt, which is the voltage, minus 2 volt, which is going to leave me with 3 volt divided by 10 amps. It's going to give me about 300 ohms. There is two ways we can connect an LED to a PIC microcontroller. We can connect it in current sourcing mode. This basically means we are sourcing current from the microcontroller. To switch on this LED, we're gonna need to put a logical 1 to the LED for it to become on. When the pin RB0 becomes 1, the LED is gonna be on. When the pin becomes 0, the LED is gonna be off. We could connect the LED in current syncing mode as well when we are syncing the current through the microcontroller. In this case, the anode is connected to 5 volt and the LED gets its ground through the microcontroller. To switch on the LED, we need to put 0 to pin B0. And to switch it off, we need to supply a 1. The other thing I would like to discuss before we can write our code is the delay functions. XC8 has got built-in delay millisecond and delay microsecond function that we can use to create a time-based delay rather than cycle count delays. If we call delay millisecond, this can generate a delay in millisecond, and delay in microsecond can generate delay in microsecond. In order to achieve this, these micros require a prior definition of preprocessor symbol extol frequency. As we learned in our previous tutorial, in the header files, we could define our frequency of oscillator. In this case, we're gonna work with 8 megahertz. An error will result if these micros are used without defining oscillator frequency symbol or if the delay period requested is too large. For very large delays, it's always good to call this function multiple times. Let's say we created the defined extol frec 8 megs and we want to generate 1 second delay. We can just call delay millisecond 50 20 times. Gonna loop it 20 times to generate a 1 second, because one second is 1000 millisecond, which is 50 millisecond times 20. To switch on and off an LED, all we need is to set the direction of the port, because if we want to switch on an LED, it means we have to send an output to the port. To set the direction of the port to become an output, we need to set the trace register to 0. To set it to 1, it means the port is gonna read, it's gonna become an input. If I specify trace bit dot RC1 equals to 0, it simply means only the port C bit 1 it is an output. Once I've set the direction of the port, then all I need is to send an output 1 to switch on something which is connected to the port, or send an output 0 to switch it off. The register to use is the LED register, especially if you are using the PIC 18 series microcontrollers. You could use the port register as well, it's going to work, but it's not a reliable way to write to a port. The best way is to use the LED. Always use the LED if the microcontroller has this register. Note that the PIC 16F series don't have this LED register, so if you want to switch on or off an LED, you'll have to use the port register. If I say LED B equals to FF, then the whole port B is going to become on. If I specify LED B port RB0 equals to 1, then only a single bit of port B0 is going to become 1. As we learned from the previous tutorial, I included my header file, start my main program. The first thing is to set the direction of the port. I'm going to use port B to connect my LED, only one LED, so I'm going to use port B0. I'm going to set it to 0 to become an output. I'm gonna use the OSCON register, set it to use internal oscillator at 8 megahertz. I'm gonna create a while one loop so that my program can keep on looping continuously. And all I need is just to write one line of code. I'm gonna set my LED bit to become the complement of my LED bit. If my LED bit was 0, then I'm gonna complement it, it's gonna become 1. Then I just create 1 second delay. If it was 0, then the LED is gonna start it off. After 1 second delay, it's gonna be on. After 1 second, it's gonna be off, and so on. Let's go to our circuit and run our circuit. Okay. It's on for 1 second and off for 1 second. Let me stop it. Let me add another diode. I'm gonna click to my diode. Connect it here. Gonna need a series resistor. Okay, it's not neat, I'm just for demonstration. Then I'm gonna go to my code to include this LED as well. You're gonna see how easy it is. Okay, to make it simple, I'm just gonna set B1 to become an output as well. Then all I need is to copy the same code. Then I'm gonna say after I switch on the first LED. Then whatever it on port B1, I'm gonna complement it as well, then go through a 1 second delay. Let me build my program. Build successful. Let me go to my code. Then I'm gonna run my program again. And it's on. Then I go to the second one, on, then off, and so on, then on, then on, then off. So basically, this is how you can switch on an LED. You just say let, and you specify the port. If I say let B, then it's gonna be the whole port which is gonna become on. But if I specify the specific bit, then it's gonna be that specific bit which is gonna become off. This is basically how you can switch on and off an LED. If you don't want to use the complement method, you could say let bit equals to zero. Then I can create a delay. Can we just delete this? I could say okay, I'm just gonna use one LED to show you this demonstration. I'm just gonna say let bit 0 equals to 0. It means to switch off the LED. Then after one delay second, then I can switch it on again. I can switch it on. I can say let B 0 equals to 1, then one delay second. Then it's gonna be on for once, off for 1 second, and one on for 1 second. Let me build the project again. Okay. Gonna run it. As you could see, it's doing exactly the way it was doing before, on and off. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive more tutorials in the future. And to learn more about this tutorial, please visit connecting light emitting diode to a PIC microcontroller page on our Student Companion website. Thank you.